See, we talked about reactor regenerated systems. Just quickly run through what we have already said. For this type of rate functions, we have formulated the population balance equations some time back, and we have got those results. We will not do it again. I will just set out what we have already done, where we have shown that F 1 is minus of q times alpha s of alpha minus of 1, 1 minus of s to the power of beta. F 2 is q beta s alpha 1 minus of s beta minus of 1, where alpha is 1 by k 1 t 1 bar, beta is 1 by k 2 t 2 bar. This is something we have done. Okay. Now, for some cases we have taken an example and showed what are the mean values and so on. What I want to do now is use this result to look at some work that was done in this department some time ago. That is use of reactions for recovery of carbon dioxide. I will just set out the equations. K2CO3 plus H2O plus CO2 gives you twice KH CO3, and then twice KH CO3 giving you K2 CO3 plus H2O plus CO2. Now, if you this is a model reaction, what we are having here is carbon dioxide is picked up by potassium carbonate to give you potassium bicarbonate, and potassium bicarbonate decomposes to give you potassium carbonate. So that the two equipments, if I call this as R1 reactor, if I call this as R2 the regenerator, if you can appropriately bring them together, you can continuously remove carbon dioxide for some purposes. Okay. So, what you have, let me just put it out in the context, you have a reactor, you have another regenerator, solids are circulating between the two, you have carbon dioxide plus moisture, okay, goes in and comes out, okay. Then you have air comes out, okay. So that carbonate circulates between the two environments, okay. Is it clear? Now, this is R1, this is R2, okay. Now, if instead of using air, if you use CO2 itself, then this carbon dioxide you can recover for some uses. Okay. So, if you really want to recover carbon dioxide, then you can use CO2 for the fluidizing gas and then recover the carbon dioxide. Is that clear? Now, what we have done in the previous sec is that we have assumed certain form of the rate functions in R1 and R2, and we have determined the populations, the activity distributions and so on. So, we want to use that result to understand how we can explain this particular data. The question is, there is some experimental data that has been found, and so the data is given here. For value of alpha 1.86, value of beta 1.03, the mean value, this S 1 and S 2, they are mean values here. I have not put a bar on the top. S 1 is given as 0.45, S 2 is given as 0.873. So, you have to verify whether this model that we have developed, this is the model. The model is this, model says F 1 is this, F 2 is this, and given the values of alpha and beta as 1.86 or 1.03, what is the mean values that we should expect from the model, and what are the mean values given in this experiment? Can we tell how good is the model? Is this clear? This is the problem that we want to solve. How do we do this? The procedure is that we first find the value of Q. given. So, to find the value of q, we do integral f 1 ds. Okay. What is f 1? F 1 is minus of q. What is the value of alpha? Value of alpha is 1.86. Just to make the integration easier, I am just putting it as 2. When you go home and do this, you can do 1.86. Integral s to the power of alpha minus 1. So, s 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 minus beta, I take it as 1 ds. Okay. Is it all right? So, this is the, this is equal to 1. This is how we calculate or estimate the value of q. Is it okay? So, what is the value of q? Q equal to, let us integrate, 1 equal to minus of 2 times q within brackets s squared by 2 minus of s cube by 3. All right. 1 equal to minus of 2 q. So, it is 1 by 6. So, it is minus of, or q equal to minus of 3. Is it okay? Now, let us see the, if there is consistency, whether we get the same value of q as minus 3 from the other, from f 2. So, integral 1 equal to 0 to 1 f 2, what is f 2? F 2 is minus of q beta, beta is 1, s alpha is 2, 1 minus of s beta minus of 1 is 0. So, that is minus of q s square ds 0 to 1, that gives you 1 equal to q times s cube by 3 0 to 1, or it also gives you q equal to, implies q equal to minus 3. All right. So, it is consistent, f 1 and f 2 are consistent. So, we know what is f 1. So, f 1 from our this one gives you 3, alpha is 2, s to the power of 2 minus of 1, that is 1, 1 minus of 1 minus of s beta is 1. So, if there is 6 s into 1 minus of s, that is f 1. F 2 equal to, f 2 is 3, beta is 1, 3 s squared. Is it all right? So, what is s 1 bar, mean value of s 1? Integral s f 1 ds 0 to 1. Is it okay? The mean value of s. And what is s? What is the meaning of s in this problem? Meaning of s is carbonate. The carbonate fraction in the reactor. Meaning of s in the regenerator also is the same, carbonate fraction. Okay. So, you would expect the carbonate fraction in the reactor to be less because it is getting consumed, carbonate fraction in the regenerator to be more because it is getting regenerated. Is that clear? So, 0. So, what is this equal to? So, let me substitute for f 1. So, it is, let me do it in the next page, s 1 bar equal to integral s 6 s times 1 minus of s ds. That comes to 6 times s squared 1 minus of s ds integral 0 to 1. So, that is 6 times s cube by 3 s to the power of 4 by 4 0 to 1. That comes to s 6 1 by 12, it is about 0.5. So, s 1 bar turns out as 0.5. Okay. What is s 2 bar? S 2 bar is integral s times f 2 ds 0 to 1, integral 0 to 1 3 s cubed ds, that is equal to 3 s to the power of 4 by 4 0 to 1. So, that is about 0.75. Is it okay? Now, the result says it is 0.45. So, if you just compare s 1 bar and s 2 bar. So, experimentally it is 0.45 and then 0.873, and then this is the experiment. Model gives you 0.5 and 0.75. Okay. 0.5 and 0.75. Now, the context to this exercise is, whenever we find your model does something very different from the data, so you should look at the model. It's not, model is not satisfactory. You have to look at what's been the assumptions you have made and what you can do to improve the model. Okay, that's the important thing. And in this particular case, I want to appreciate this problem. The problem is, let me just do it once again. Materials coming in and going out. Okay. Now, if this is the regenerator, this is the reactor. Okay. So, what happens in the regenerator? Carbonate is getting generated. Okay. So, you would expect that the way the model has been formulated, if you look back at the rate function says K1 times S. That means, it reacts throughout the particle. As per the model, the reaction takes place throughout the particle. But in the shrinking core, as we have said with gas solid reaction, there is an interface between the reactants and the solid. There is an interface where the reaction occurs. Or in other words, we have modeled the system using an assumption of uniform reaction throughout the particle. While in shrinking core, you find that the particle actually reacts at the gas solid interface. Okay. So, this is the weakness of the assumption. Now, when would this assumption be very good? This would be very good if it is a highly porous particle, so that the reaction is able to take place everywhere. Okay. The fact that this data does not fit so well implies that that assumption, that this rate function may not be as good. That is the meaning of this. So, the important point I want you to appreciate here is that every time you postulate a model, model does not quite describe the data, then we look at the model and make refinements to the model. So, that is the point of this exercise. Okay.
Sir, yeah. By looking at the reaction rates, how do you say it is uniform?
How do you say? It is formulated because it is a K1 times S, which means that there is a when we say reaction rate is K1 times C, which means that everywhere in the equipment it is reacting at that rate. But in the shrinking core, the particle and the gas, wherever is the interface only, it is reacting, it is not reacting everywhere. So, that assumption that we have made in this formulation is not what is happening in the reaction. So, the two are not consistent, that is why we are seeing a difference. Okay. Is this point clear to all of you? That is why we are not finding such a good agreement. Okay. Let us go to an equally important exercise, which is of course, those of you who have looked at the cat cracking. What is in the cat cracking process? We have a catalyst, okay, and this catalyst is porous, and as the reaction proceeds, the catalyst has a deposition of coke. So, let me, this is problem number 6. So, this is the cracking reactor, okay, this is the cracking reactor where gas oil is coming in, this is gas oil, say, okay, and it is regenerated with air. So, as this reaction proceeds, the catalyst which is present in the reactor, there is coke deposition. And because of coke deposition, which is uniform throughout the particle, and this deactivates the catalyst. So, the first part of the exercise is that what is the extent to which this catalyst is getting deactivated, that is the first part. The second part is how do we run this process, second part. Third part is that what kind of conversions we should expect in our process. There are three aspects to this. Well, let us do it one by one. First part says the reactor gets deactivated by this rate function K1 times S1, where S1 now refers to mean values. What do we mean? Previously, we talked about distributions. Now, we are not talking about distribution. We are saying R1 is simply K1 times S1, S1 bar with a minus sign, indicating that the rate at which this is how we are formulating the problem. Because we already found out how to determine S1 bar. We have done that problem already, correct? For the case, we know what is the value of the mean value of the catalyst activity, because we have done this problem just now. Now, what we are saying is that let us now look at this reactor deactivating by this function K1 times S1 bar. S1 bar is known. Similarly, R2, which is the regenerator, where it is getting regenerated by this kind of function. R2 equal K2 times S2 bar. This is given to you, K2 and K1 values are given to you. Okay. Now, what this problem now says is, if S2 bar minus S1 bar, the mean values, S1 and S2 are mean values, this is, let us say it is 0.3. What is being said? That the mean value of activity S1 bar and mean value of S2 bar is about 0.3. this how the process is run. You can run the process at different values depending upon what you feel is appropriate to you. In this particular problem, we are saying it is S2 bar minus of S1 bar is point. It is given. The question is, show that the optimum size ratio of W1, that means optimum size ratio of the reactor and regenerator, that is given by this square root of K2 by K1. This is the first part of the exercise. Okay. So, let us try to do that problem. So, I will do it once again. We have reactor, we have regenerator. Okay. Solids are circulating between these two. Now, we are writing a material balance for coke deposition. This is what is responsible for the loss of activity, correct? Or we can also write material balance for activity itself, because we understand that activity is because of coke form, loss of activity because of coke formation. So, V naught times A2 bar or S2 bar, I mean I have written A2 bar here, V naught times A1 bar minus K1 W1 A1 bar equal to 0. Is it all right what we are saying? V naught times this is reactor 2, this is reactor 1. Material is from reactor 2, material is coming at an activity of A2 bar. It is flowing at V0. Similarly, it is going out at V0 at A1 bar. And the rate at which the activity is lost is given by K1 bar A1 bar. Okay? So, this is equation 1. This is for the reactor. Okay? Similarly, we can do for V0 A1 bar minus V0 A2 bar plus K2 W1 A2 bar equal to 0. Is it all right? But 1 minus or 1, 1. Is it okay? Yes or no? All right. Now, we want to solve these two. Let us quickly solve. So, what I have written, please tell me if it is okay. T1 bar equal to A2 bar minus of A1 bar divided by K1 A1 bar. T2 bar equal to A2 bar minus of A1 bar divided by K2 times 1 minus of A2 bar. Is it okay? Look at this. So, I just call this as equation 3 and equation 4. Do we all agree with this? Yes or no? Now, A2 bar minus of A1 bar is actually a process design decision. You will decide how you will run your process. That means, A2 bar gives you the average activity in the reactor and regenerator, A1 in that difference is a process decision. You will find various values. In this case, it is given as 0.3. Okay. In other words, T1 bar plus T2 bar, if I add these two, A2 minus of A1 bar within brackets 1 by K1 A1 bar plus 1 by K2 times 1 minus of A2 bar. Okay. The question we ask now is, we have made a decision of what is A2 bar minus of A1 bar. Okay. Let us say that is fixed for a process. Therefore, if you want to find the best choice or the minimum size of this equipment W1 and W2, you have to minimize this quantity with respect to A1 bar or A2 bar, but the difference is fixed. That means, what we are saying is that A2 bar minus of A1 bar is fixed, okay, it is omega. And then what is the best choice that you can make for A1 and A2? How do you solve that problem? You solve this problem by recognizing that T1 bar plus T1 bar. So, this is omega 1 divided by K1 A1 bar, I can say plus 1 by K2 times, what is this? A2 is? I should say omega plus A1, is it all right? So, let me say A2 minus of A1 bar is omega. So, A2 bar equal to, correct, you are right, minus, okay, all right. Now, we can differentiate this and find the best values. Please do that, differentiate this and find the best values. So, you differentiate with respect to A1, set it equal to 0, okay. I have done this here. So, 0 equal to minus omega. This is what I get. Please tell me whether I got it right. A1 squared plus 1 by K2. I have removed the omega. A2 bar. I have removed the omega from here. Is it okay? Please tell me. I have differentiated this, okay, and then replace the omega in terms of A1, A2. Okay? Yes or no? Please differentiate with respect to A1 and in the result replace omega in terms of A1, A2. This is the result I get. Yes or no? Please, 1 or 2 is not enough. Is it okay? So, what do we get now? So, we get K1 divided by K2 to the power of half equal to 1 minus of A2 bar divided by A1 bar. Is this correct? Yes or no? All right. So, shall we go forward? Let us look at our first equation. T1 bar is given, T2 bar is given by this. So, from here K1 T1 bar I can write. So, I will write like this. Please tell me if it is okay. K1 T1 bar divided by K2 T2 bar equal to 1 minus of A2 bar divided by A1 bar. Is this okay? That comes from equation that we have written earlier. Is it okay? All right. Now, you also have this. Let me put this in here. K1 divided by K2 to the power of half equal to 1 minus of A2 bar divided by A1 bar. So, with this, what kind of simplifications can we make regarding T1 by T2? So, I mean, it follows directly from here. T1 by T2 bar is simply K2 by K1. Okay, this is what is asked. If you look at here, see W1 by W2 is simply T1 by T2, correct? So, K2 by K1, that is what we get. So, what do we get here? So, it simplifies as T1 bar divided by T2 bar equal to K2 divided by K1 to the power of half. That is same as what you have to show. You have to show is W1 by W2 is same as T1 bar by T2 bar. So, what we are saying is that the size ratio, the point that is being put across here is that size ratio for these recirculating systems really depends upon the rate constants. So, essentially your catalyst design, so if you have a rate constants, so essentially it depends upon your catalyst, how good or how bad it is. On that basis only the size ratio will be determined. I mean, this is nothing unusual. I mean, this is something that we all know. The rate constants are high, then you can have smaller equipments and so on. That is what it is saying. Is it okay? Now, the next thing is, for the optimal size ratio, you find out these numbers S1, S2, T1, T2 and so on. Okay? For optimal size ratio, so if the optimal size ratio is given, what is A1 bar and A2 bar? That is our next question. That means, the size ratio is optimal is given. First, we have to find out what is S1 bar, what is S2 bar or A1 bar, A2 bar, what are the T1 bar and T2 bar. Okay? This is what we have to. So, next, let us do that now. What is given is A2 bar minus of A1 bar is 0.3. Okay? We know that K1 T1 bar by K2 T2 bar, we have derived just now, is 1 minus of A2 bar by A1 bar. We have derived just now. Now, what is K1? From our exercise, what is K1 value? 0.04 per second at 400 degrees C for Ca equal to 1.5 gram moles per liter. Okay. That means, see what happens, please appreciate, in the cat cracking system, the rate at which coke deposits really depends upon the concentration of gas in contact with the solid. So, if the gas concentration is high, to that extent the coke deposition is high. If the gas concentration is low, all those issues are there with the cat cracking system. So, here it says if Ca is 1.5, it is 0.05 per second. Actually, what we are given a little later, in fact, these two are related, that we are operating at 5 grams per liter, that is the concentration, and we wants to operate at 60% conversion. So, what is the value of Ca for this, for the problem we want to solve? See, 5 grams per liter, if the extent of reaction is 60%, what is this A value in contact with the solid in the reactor? Ca corresponding to 60% conversion is what? Ca equal to Ca0 times 1 minus of x, which is 5 multiplied by 0.6, which is 3 grams per liter. Correct? Is it okay what we are saying? Sir, thank you. 2 grams per liter. Okay. So, If K1 is 0.5 at Ca equal to 1.5, what is K1 value corresponding to? 2 grams per liter. This is something common sense says that it will be proportionally higher. So, K1 value, K1 at Ca equal to 2 grams per liter equal to 0.05 multiplied by 2 divided by 1.5. Is it okay? You all agree? Is it all right? How much is it? 0.066, shall we say, per second. Is it all right? So, K1, so for us to proceed further, the value of K1 is 0.066 and K2 is 0.04. Is it okay? No, K1 is 0.066. That is what we calculated just now. 1.5, our value is 2, na? Just now we said, what I am saying is, see, we have said a little later that it is actually going to be operating at 2 grams per liter. It said a little later, it should have been said earlier, unfortunately, it said later. So, we calculate value of Ca corresponding to, and therefore calculate K1 at 2 grams per liter. Yeah, is it okay? So, that is 0.66, K1 is 0.66, K2 is 0.04. So, let us find out what is K1 T1 bar. Let me state once again, K1 T1 bar divided by K2 T2 bar equal to 1 minus of A2 bar divided by A1 bar. K1 is 0.066 T1 bar, and what is K2? What is K2? 0.04 T2 bar. What is T1 bar by T2 bar? We have also done that. What is T1 bar by T2 bar? So, let us substitute that also. 0.66 T1 bar by T2 bar is K2 by K2 by K1, correct? K2 by K1 to the power of half. Okay. So, that becomes 0.4 by 0.66 to the power of half equal to 1 minus of A2 bar divided by A1 bar. Is it all right? Yes or no? So, what is the value? No, please tell me all of the numbers. So, we know that A2 bar minus of A1 bar is 0.3 is given. So, this gives us A2 bar equal to A1 bar equal to what? Tell me. Is this clear what we are saying? A2 bar, this A1 bar, A2 bar minus A1 bar is given. Therefore, you can do all the manipulations and give me the results. What is A1 bar and what is A2 bar? What is the answer? I get a value of A1 bar as 0.307. A1 bar is 0.307 I got, and A2 bar is 0.607. Anybody else? Okay. Anybody else, please? Is it all right?
So, that means we are operating regenerated at 500 degrees.
Yeah, regenerate, see, it says, just a minute, how do you say that? 6.2, yeah. K2, yeah. See, the temperatures of regenerator is always higher than the reactor because you have to burn off the coke. That data is given. That data is given.
Yeah.
Why K1 is 0.66? Yeah. Good. See, what I am saying is, this 6.2 is related to 6.3. It should have been said earlier. In the 6.3, what they are saying is that this gas oil cracking that goes on in the petroleum industry, with the inlet gas are coming in 5 grams per liter and 60% conversion is typical. Therefore, the gas solids in contact with the gases, gas concentration is about 2 grams per liter. Okay. Because it is 2 grams per liter and that data K1 is at 0.5 corresponding to Ca is 1.5 and our Ca values are more like 2. That is why we have upgraded this number and said that it is this is of this 0.5 multiplied by 2 by 1.5. That means, higher the concentration, higher is the coke formation. That is what is being said. Is that clear? Is it okay now? Okay. All right. Now, we have A1 bar is 0.607, A2 bar is 0.307. Then the next we have to find out is, what are the, find S1, S2 we have done, T1 bar, T2 bar. How do you find T1 bar, T2 bar? we go to our equation number 1, k 1 t 1 bar equal to a 2 minus of a 1 bar divided by k 1 a 1. This is our equation 1, correct? This is something that we have written earlier. Sir. Thanks. Okay. Now, can we find out T 1 bar? So, T 1 bar equal to 0.3, K 1 is 0.066, A 1 bar is 0.307. Is it correct? 14.3, correct? 14.8. Now, what is T 2 bar? T 2 bar equal to, you can do the same thing, A 2 bar minus of A 1 bar divided by K 2 times 1 minus of A 2 bar. Okay. So, what is T 2 bar equal to? 0.3 divided by 0.04 multiplied by 1 minus of 0.607. Okay. How much is it? 19. Everybody? 19. Okay. Is it all right? Okay. Now, we have set up the equations for the dual bed circulating systems, and we have said that we have this reactor and regenerator and material going between the them at V naught, and in the reactor the reaction takes place, and in the regenerator the coke deposited gets regenerated and so on. Now, our equation is R 1 is minus of K 1 S bar, R 2 is K 2 times 1 minus of S 2 bar. I sometimes use A here instead of S. So, you know, both are interchangeably used. So, do recognize that. Our reaction rate expression we said is minus of R A K R C A times S 1 bar, where K R C A 0 is 8.67 per minute. We would like to find out what is the size of W 1, what is the size of W 2. I think that is the point that we want to answer now, because we have done the modeling and then found out what is T 1 bar and what is T 2 bar that we already done. Let us see how to do this. Now, what is our material balance for component A in the reactor? What is our material balance for component A in the reactor? You have this reactor here, you have this regenerator here, okay, okay, all right. So, this is reactor, this is regenerator, this is reactor, okay. This is regenerator. Okay. Now, you have these products coming out, products. This is FA0. So, what is our material balance? Input, output, generation equal to 0 at steady state. Therefore, size of the equipment W1 is FA0 XA by minus of RA. I will put RA1 here. Okay, RA1. Okay, this is RA1. All right. So, what is FA0? We are saying FA0 is 16 kg per second. We have already said that. 16 kg per second, and the reaction extent is XA is 0.6, that is also given. And what is KRCA S1 bar? What is KRCA? We have given KRCA 0 is 8.67 per minute. So, what is CA then? CA is CA 0 times 1 minus of X. Therefore, CA is that number is CA 0 is 5 and 1 minus of X is 0.4 because X is 0.6. Therefore, we find that KRCA is 8.67 multiplied by 0.4, which is KRCA, and S 1 bar is already, we have derived this 0.307, this is already done. Therefore, how do you find out RA 1? RA 1 is simply KRCA times S 1 bar. KRCA is given here, S 1 bar is given here. Therefore, we can substitute here and find out what is the size of W 1. Okay. Let us do that now. Let us do that now. When you do that, what do we find? FA 0 is 16, this is 0.6. Okay. Now, 8.67 by 0.4 points, this we have multiplied by 60 to convert this is per minute, that is what we have, because our numbers are given in minute. Okay. Therefore, 8.67, why it is 8.67, why it is 8.67, okay. Oh, 8.67 per minute, correct. So, 8.67 is per minute, okay, not per hour. Okay. Therefore, what I have done is that 8.67 per minute I have divided by 60 to get per hour. Okay, because okay, is that clear? So that we get V naught equal to W 1 by T 1 bar. This is 540 kg. Therefore, divided by 14, we get 38 kg per second. Let's go through this once again. What have we done? What we have done is
W1 is FA0 XA by minus of RA1. We only have to substitute all the numbers to get our answers. This is 16 kg per second. While this 8.67 is given per minute, I have just converted to second. That is why I have divided by 60. Okay. That is why we get size of this equipment W1 is 540 kg. And what is V0? V0 is circulation. So, V0 is simply W1 divided by T1 bar. We already found T1 bar to be 14 seconds. We already done this. Therefore, we get V0 to be 38 kg per second, which means we must circulate, the solids between the two reaction equipment. Let me just run through this once again. What we are saying is that this is V0, that means we are saying that this V0 must be circulated at 38 kg per second, that is what we are saying, okay. Is that clear what we are saying? So, because T1 bar is already calculated as 14 seconds, we find V0 is 38 kg per second, okay. Now, what is V2? V2 by definition is V0 multiplied by T2 bar, we have also found out T2 bar to be 19 seconds. Therefore, we find W2 equal to 722 kg, okay. So, what we have done now, we have done this design for a reactor regenerated system where we have done an optimal choice of T1 bar and T2 bar, okay. Based on that optimal choice of T1 bar and T2 bar, we determined W1 because we knew the reaction kinetics, and based on that we found out V0 and hence we found out W2, okay. Therefore, what is the production rate of the products from reactor? Because that is what we want. We want to convert gas oil to some useful products. Therefore, our production rate is 16 multiplied by 0.6. 9.6 kg of products are coming out of reactor, okay. And therefore, production rate divided by V0. What is this ratio? 9. P divided by V0. How much is that? V0 is the reverse. V0 by P. So, the circulation divided by production, 38 by 9.6 is 3.8. So, the important point that I want to put across to you here is the following. That is, if you have a reactor regenerator, this is reactor, okay, I will call it R1, this is regenerator. So, reactor is reactor, okay, and R2 is regenerator. So, what we are saying is that in reactor regenerator system, V0 divided by FA0, okay, is typically supposed to be 4 to 6, okay. It is supposed to be 4 to 6. In our case, we have found V0 divided by production rate is about 3.8, okay, or V0 divided by FA0 is slightly less, okay. What we are trying to say is that the industry norm is in the range of 4 to 6, which means we must circulate the solids which at about 4 to 6 times the rate at which you want to process the gases. This is the industrial practice, okay. This is for the case of K1 is so much and K2 is so much. K2 is, K1 is 0.5 per second and K2 is 0.4 per second at 500 degrees centigrade, this is at 400 degrees C. Now, of course, there is a great interest in improving our catalysts and so on, and we can do that, and then the moment you have better catalysts, of course, you will have to redesign your systems to give you the appropriate optimal choices, okay. And another point to be borne in mind is that our reaction rate in this, in the reactor where the gas oil is coming in, is S1 bar KRCA, which is the rate at which the reaction takes place in this equipment, where this KRCA0 is experimentally found to be 8.67 per minute. In other words, we can improve the catalyst to improve these reaction rates so that we get higher productions, okay. That is the important thing. That means for a given circulation, if you want higher productions, we have to improve the catalyst, okay. Of course, these are all important features, people understand this. So, cut this long story short, what we are trying to say is that in reactor regenerator system, we must circulate the solids at roughly 4 times the rate at which we process the gases. This is the industry practice. And that is something that we would do in our design so that we get our results of our choice.
All right, let us go to the next one. Our next, we have a reactor. Please talk to me. We have a reactor regenerated system in which our rate function R1 and our rate function R2 are K minus k1 plus k2. Okay. We started this exercise some time back, okay, where we said that whenever we have a rate function which are 0 order, what does 0 order mean? 0 order means that the time required for complete consumption of the particle is finite. Okay. And these are all well mixed vessels. That means we are looking at well mixed vessels. Well mixed vessels means what? That the RTD is the exponential RTD, correct? We have done that. The RTD is exponential RTD, and then if tau is the time for complete consumption, there is a finite fraction of material which is in the equipment which is completely consumed. Okay. And what is that fraction? We said that fraction which is completely consumed is 0 to infinity, tau to infinity e raise to the power of minus of t by t bar dt divided by t bar. We have done that, correct? This is the fraction which is completely consumed, because any material which is staying for a time more than tau will be completely consumed. Therefore, this, what is this fraction? We have integrated this, and if we call alpha equal to tau by t bar, we said that fraction is e raised to the power of minus of alpha. Okay. What we are saying is that in a stirred vessel, there is finite fraction of material which has a time of residence greater than tau, and therefore, that material will be completely consumed. Because it is completely consumed, it can be seen as either completely consumed or completely regenerated, whichever may be the case depending upon what is our situation. Therefore, the fraction that is completely consumed is e to the power of minus of alpha in a stirred tank. Or in other words, if you have a single vessel, let me state this once again because it is important. If you have a single equipment, material coming in, material going out, okay, e to the power of minus of alpha tau is time for complete consumption, okay, and then t bar is the residence time, okay, then this is the fraction which is completely consumed or completely regenerated. Okay. Is this clear? Therefore, in the context of population balance, if it is an instance of a reactor in which there is only deactivation, that means your rate function is of this form, then distribution function will have a discontinuity. The discontinuity will be at s equal to 0, because it is completely consumed. Completely consumed means what? The property value is s equal to 0. And what is that fraction? We said that fraction is e to the power of minus of alpha. Is this clear to all of you? If you have a fluidized bed, for example, if you have solids coming in and solids going out, and the solids are reacting as per this rate function, then there is a finite fraction of material which is completely consumed, and that fraction is given by that fraction is given by e to the power of minus of alpha, okay, and therefore the distribution function f1 will have a discontinuity at s equal to 0. Okay. Therefore, we say that if that quantity is k0 times delta of s minus of 0 plus a continuous part. Okay. Is this clear? Physically, what it means is that there is a finite fraction which belongs to delta s minus 0. That means its property value is s equal to 0. If this rate function is of the form R2 equal to k2, if this form, then the fraction that is completely consumed will be, let us say, it is f2 equal to, I am denoting this as L1. I will give you a reason why I denote it as L1. Okay. The fraction that is completely consumed, if it is of this form, it is regenerated. So, the discontinuity is at s equal to 1. Is it clear? Is it okay? Now, the context is this problem. Our context is this. Our context is this. Okay, this is reactor, this is regenerator. R 1 is minus of K 1, R 2 is plus K 2. Therefore, F 1 is some G 1 at S plus K 0 delta of S minus 0. F 2 is G 2 of S plus L 1 delta of S minus 1. I draw your attention to this once again, that I said, please just give me a minute. I said, when there is a single fluid bed, this fraction K 0 is e to the power of minus of alpha. Okay. When there is a single, when there are two of them, then this fraction is determined by the interaction between both. Therefore, it is not e to the power of minus K 0 alpha. It is not this, something else. We will derive that now. What is important to recognize here is that function f 1 and f 2 have a discontinuous part and a continuous part. Okay. And then we should be able to derive what is K 0, what is L 1, what is G 1, what is G 2. This is what we want to do now. Is this clear? Okay. Now, the general approach here is that whenever we have a function which is unbounded, we try to get rid of it. You see. We try to get rid of it and look at the homogeneous equation, generate boundary conditions and appropriately account for the discontinuity. Okay, the same procedure. We have done part of this before, but I will run through this once again. We have already derived I will write it down, but you know we have done this when we met last time. So, I thought I will save some time. We did this last time. Sorry. Thank you. Okay. Is this something that we have, how did you derive this? By setting up what happens at the boundaries. Okay. We can do it again, but we won't do it now because we will lose some time. Now, what is our population balance? Let me just write it here, just for G 1, sorry, for this is for reactors G 2 minus of G 1 minus of D by, I have written D. Sometimes I write S, sometimes G 1 R 1 T 1 bar equal. So, maybe I will write it again. 1 minute, I will just write it again. For reactor is G 2 minus of G 1 minus of D by D. I have written A and S. I do not know. I will write, I have written A here. So, let us continue with that. G 1 R 1 T 1 bar equal to 0. Similarly, G 1 minus of G 2 minus of D by D A of G 2 R 2 T 2 bar equal to 0. Okay. Is it all right? Now, what is the procedure that we have adopted for solving this? We simply add these two, correct? And then, so let us add 1 and 2. What is the equation number I have given here? I call this as 1, I call this as 2. Suppose you add 1 and 2. What do we get? So, we get G 1 R 1 T 1 bar plus G 2 R 2 T 2 bar D by D A equal to 0. So, that gives us G 1 R 1 T 1 bar plus G 2 R 2 T 2 bar equal to constant. Is it all right? Okay. We agree. Now, to find the constant of integration, we have got all the boundary conditions here. We can see how it looks. G 1 R 1 T 1 bar at 0, G 1 R 2 T 2, 1 is K 0, 1 is minus K 0. therefore constant of integration is 0. Is it okay? Because we have seen g1 r1 t1 bar at 0 and g2 r2, this is minus k0, this is plus k0. Okay, therefore constant of integration is 0. Is it okay? So since g1 r1 t1 bar equal to minus k0, g2 r2 t2 bar is plus k0, we have constant equal to 0. Therefore, this our equation becomes g1 r1 t1 bar plus g2 r2 t2 bar equal to 0. So, what I have done, I have said g2 equal to g1 r1 t1 bar divided by r2, sorry, r2 t2 bar, okay, with a minus. Thank you. Now, I put alpha equal to 1 by k1 t1 bar and beta equal to 1 by k2 t2 bar. With this, I get g2 equal to g1 beta by alpha. Is it correct? Please tell me. G2 equal to g1 beta by alpha. Seems all right. Okay, good. Now, we can substitute for g2 in our equation 1, correct? We can substitute for g2 here, okay? And then simplify and so on. I have done that. This one? Next one? Sorry. I have written it correctly here. I did it wrongly here. Okay. Let's go further now, please. Substitute for this in our first equation. I get, please see if it is all right, g1 by alpha beta minus of g1 plus dg1 by alpha dA. So, this is how it looks, our equation 1. Please see if it is okay. Say substituting for g2, dissolve it is substituting for g2 in our equation 1. Our equation 1 is this. This is equation 1 and it simplifies like this. Please tell me if it is okay. So, finally, it simplifies as dg1 by dA is g1 times alpha minus a beta. Is this okay? Whether this representation is correct, you please tell me. Hey, listen, we should not make any mistake here. I have written g2 as g1 beta by alpha. This is okay. G1 is all right. Minus d by dA of g1 r1. So, r1 is negative, therefore, this has become a plus. So, this statement is correct. So, this equation is correct. Okay. Now, please help me to simplify this. Can we solve this now? What is the solution? So, you get ln g1 by q equal to alpha minus of beta times a. Is it all right? Can we write this? Okay. Now, therefore, g1 equal to q times exponential of alpha minus of beta times a. So, this is the solution. Okay. Okay, thank you. What is g2? I have written as q times beta by alpha exponential of alpha minus of beta times a. Is this correct? Yes. Our solution is complete if you find the values of k0 and L1 in terms of system parameters, which is alpha and beta are the system parameters. So, let us try to do that. For that, what I have done, integral 0 to 1 g1 dA is 1 minus of k0. Integral 0 to 1 g2 dA is 1 minus of L1. Is it all right? It is by definition. Please, our definitions are here. This is our definition. So, integral f1 dA is 1. Therefore, g1 dA will 1 minus of k0, g2 dA will be 1 minus of L1. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, let us go further now. So, what is plus? It has to be plus, na? See, please don't forget our physics is what? The function f1 and function f2 has a continuous part and a discontinuous part. So it's plus. Okay. All right. Now, what I have done is that integral g1 dA. Can we integrate g1 dA? Integral 0 to 1, what is g1? Q times exponential of alpha minus of beta times A dA. Okay. That is equal to 1 minus of k 0. I have integrated this, and you please see whether we have done it right or not. Q minus of alpha minus of beta within brackets of this is what I get. Is it all right?
Yes.
Okay, we will keep this. If some manipulations are required, I have done the manipulations. Okay. Now, let us look at g1. Where is g1? A little messy, but anyway, this is g1. What is g1 at 0? G1 0. G1 0 is q. I will write. Okay. G1 0 is q. Okay. Now, what else do we have? I have got something else. I have done. I have written g1 0 by alpha from 3. What is 3? G1 T1 R 0 equal to minus k. Is it correct? So, can I write this as minus of G1 at 0 by alpha equal to minus k 0? Can I write this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, that tells me that G1 0 is k 0 alpha and G1 0 is also equal to q. Therefore, our solution looks like this. So, what I am saying is that this q, I will replace it as k 0 alpha. Is it all right? So, help me now. So, I am saying 1 minus of k 0 equal to k 0 alpha divided by alpha minus of beta e to the power of minus of 1. So, this simplifies and gives you k 0 as 1 divided by 1 plus alpha minus of beta e to the power of alpha minus of beta minus 1. Okay. Now, just to cut this long story short, and we can do some more manipulations, I will not do this. I will simply write this. You can do it yourself. It is not so difficult. Okay. I get this 1 plus alpha by alpha minus of beta e to the power of alpha minus of beta minus 1. You can do this yourself. Okay. So, what we have tried to do is, we have found out g1, we have found out g2, we have found out k0, we have found out l1. In other words, you have completely specified the distributions in terms of system properties alpha and beta. Okay. The important point is to recognize that k0 and l1 depends on choice of the operation alpha and beta. Okay. That is the point that that comes through this exercise. The property distributions are done. So, okay, the property distributions, I will just all the numbers it will write down. Alpha is known, k 0 is known, l 1 is known, g 1 is known, g 2 is known. Correct. Let me just write here g 1, you have done this. G 1 is k 0 alpha e to the power of alpha minus of beta times a, and g 2 is l 1 beta e raised to the power of minus of alpha. This is, we know all this. So, we know the complete solution. Is this clear? The complete solution is in front of you. So, you can see a g 1, g 2, k 0, l 1. Okay. Is this all right? What it tells us is that if you want the mean values, if you want the mean values now, you have to take the first moment of the distribution. Okay. So, if you want mean value of in reactor, so it will be s times. So I just want you to remind, let me just do one of them. S times you have k 0 alpha minus of beta times a plus this is k 0 times delta of s minus of 0 ds. This is the integral which gives you s 1. Is it all right? What is this integral? S times k 0 times delta s minus 0 ds. What is the meaning of the delta function? S equal to 0. S multiplied by k 0 delta S minus 0 ds. That integral is what? It is 0. Do you understand that? Do you understand? S times k naught times delta S minus 0 ds is 0. Is that clear? That is the definition of delta function. The delta function takes the value. See, when you multiply S delta, S times delta S minus 0 is 0. Okay. Do not make that mistake. When you do this integration, this term actually disappears. Is this clear? Is this clear to all of you? Huh? See, what is important is that you must appropriately use the property of the delta function. Okay. So, that is the point that I am trying to point out. Okay. So, what it says is that we have done the property distribution and then boundary conditions and all that we have done. The mean value I have not done. You can do it yourself and show it to me. So, what are the things we have done? We have done this. We have done this. Zero order we have done. Okay. Carbon recovery we have done. Mixed orders. See, this 4 and 5, they are exercises for you, because we have set up for various cases. So, 4 and 5 are two exercises that you should do, okay, so that you know how to apply population balance, how to write the balances properly, take things appropriately into account. So, these are very good exercises, you know, unless you write it properly, you do not get the results, okay. And all these are analytical solutions. You will get analytical solutions. So, you get, you know, there is no. So, it will be a good exercise for both, all of you. Sorry. It is plus k 2, which means that, plus I need not have written. Okay. Is it all right now? R 2 equal to k 2. No. This is wrongly written. It should be R 1 is only correct. It is wrongly written. You are right. I will make that change. It is only minus, sorry, now it is okay. R 1 is minus k 1 s, R 2 is plus k 2, okay. Please make that change, please make that change. Question number 5, this is correct, 5 is okay. So, this of course, you have done all these things, you can do it once again and show it to me, but most importantly 4 and 5 you must submit, because that I have not done here. So, whatever I have not done here, you should definitely do, and what I have not done fully also you should submit. I have not done fully, I think this particular question I have not done fully. This part I have not done. Okay, we will stop there. We will take it next time.